one really good shot now, maybe two. No, you don't. No, you must turn around and wave. Dearly beloved, we have come together in the presence of God to witness and to bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned this manner of life by his presence in first miracle at a wedding in Cana of Galilee. It signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and his church, and Holy Scripture commends it to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for they have been comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity, and when it is God's will for the procreation of children and their nurture, in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this holy union, Renee Elizabeth Kimball and Stefan Benjamin Trankins now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be married, speak now, or else forever hold your peace. I require to charge you both, here in the presence of God, that it either of you know any reason why you may not be united in marriage lawfully, and in accordance with God's word, you do now confess it. Renee, will you have this man be your husband, to live together in a covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live.
I will.
Stefan, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Will all of you witnessing these promises do all in your power to uphold Renee and Stefan in their marriage? And so say, we will.
We will.
Who presents this one?
I do.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O gracious and ever-living God, you have created us male and female in your image. Look mercifully upon this man and this woman who come to you seeking your blessing, and assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the Song of Solomon. My beloved speaks and says to me, arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. For now the winter is past, the rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth, time of singing has come, and the voice of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth its figs, and the vines are in blossom. They give forth fragrance. Arise, my love, my fair one, and come away. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm. For love is strong as death, passion fierce as the grave. Its flashes are flashes of fire, a raging flame. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can the floods drown it. If one offered for love all the wealth of his house, it would be utterly scorned. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the book of Matthew. Jesus said, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven. Everyone then who hears these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rains fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on that house, but it did not fall, because it had been founded on the rock. And everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act on them will be like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell, and great was its fall." Now when Jesus had finished saying these things, the crowds were astounded at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority, and not as their scribes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So the idea would be that by taking on the marriage vow and committing yourselves to one another for life, that you are committed to imitating, though you will never quite achieve, the kind of love that God has for us. The kind of love that God has and is demonstrated in the Hebrew scriptures when they keep breaking off and running away and down in the wilderness and giving Moses headaches. To imitate that stubborn, long-suffering, patient, enduring love, because steadfast love never gives up. But there's a flexibility in this quality of love. I don't know if you ever played tetherball growing up, but you know, you got a ball and a hook and a cord, a tether rope that's what, about 4 feet long, and the ball reaches out only so far before the tether itself will draw it back. So you have freedom in this bond that you're assuming today. Freedom to move around and to do what you need to do in the world, but only so far as that tether will hold. Now, if you're very wise and patient and kind, that tether will be a very generous one, because you will want for each other, you will want each for the other the most that person can be. You will become the guardians of each other's solitude. And in some cases, you will become the guardians of one another's health. You will become the guardians of one another's finances. You will be each other's best friend and confidant. And that tether keeps you bound. But just remember that the tether is love. And it's a really wonderful thing. So every couple that comes into a church seeking God's blessing for their marriage is actually setting themselves a vow that in this relationship you will imitate, practice, and learn about the love of God, except you will learn it right here in this relationship. Which sometimes means that you will have the ability of a skinned knee or a sore elbow, because it won't always be easy going. And the truth that each one presents to the other about himself, remember, your spouse is some days like a mirror, and they will show you things about yourself that you just as soon not see, knowing you as well as they do. But that's like a polishing process that refines us the way gold is refined in the fire. So that it's one of the best ways we know to give us our shot at becoming, which simply means to be full of God's love and able to transmit it freely and clearly like a perfect transmitter into the world. Now the thing is, it looks as if you're really just doing this for yourselves. And certainly you are, and that's not a bad thing. You're doing it for your own happiness. The positive thing about it though is that the more faithfully you live out this vow that you made today, the better place the world will be. Because other people will be comforted without even saying it by the constancy with which you love and care for one another. And by the constancy and patience and faithfulness to you extend to one another's families and one another's friends. And the way you learn as you continue to grow and mature, the wiser ways of love. So become expert. Learn what there is to know about love and kindness and sharing one another's feelings and helping one another get along in the world. And we are hereby jumping you to the graduate level seminar in love. And we know you will do well in it. And we offer you our love, our support, our gratitude, and our blessing. So would you like to get married? Yes.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poorer.
Richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Love and care.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my song of
death. This is my song.
In the name of God, I, Renee, take you, Stefan.
In the name of God, I, Renee, take you, Stefan.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
I hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and
health. Love and to cherish.
Love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death. This is my song. Bless the Lord these rings to be a sign of the vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other through Jesus Christ our Lord. Renee, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of God.
In the name of God.
Stefan, I give you this ring. As a symbol of my vow. And with all that I am. And all that I have. I honor you in the name of God. Now that Renee and Stefan have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. The congregation, please stand so that we may continue with the prayers. Let us pray together in the words our Savior Christ has taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, let us pray. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world you have made and for which your Son gave his life, and especially upon this man and this woman, whom you make one flesh in holy matrimony. Give them wisdom and devotion in the ordering of their common life, that each may be to the other a strength in need, counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. Grant that their wills may be so knit together in your will, and their spirits in your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and one another all the days of their life. Give them grace if they should hurt each other to recognize and acknowledge their fault, and to seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Make their life together a sign of Christ's love to this broken world, that unity may overcome estrangement, forgiveness heal guilt, and joy comfort. comfort, despair. Bestow on them, if it is your will, the gift and heritage of children, and the grace to bring them up to know you, to love you, and to serve you. Give them such fulfillment of their mutual affection that they may reach out in love and concern for others. Grant that all married persons who have witnessed these vows may find their lives strengthened and their loyalties confirmed. Grant that the bonds of our common humanity, by which all your children are united one to another, and the living to the dead, may be so transformed by your grace that your will may be done on earth as it is in heaven, where, O Father, with your Son and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign in perfect unity, now and forever.
Amen.
Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in sending Jesus Christ to come among us, to be born of a human mother and to make the way of the cross to be the way of life. We thank you also for consecrating the union of man and woman in his name. By the power of your Holy Spirit, pour out the abundance of your blessing upon this man and this woman. Defend them from every enemy. Lead them into all peace. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows, in their life and in their death. Finally, in your mercy, bring them to that table where your saints feast forever in your heavenly home. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God forever and ever.
Amen.
God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully with his favor look upon you and fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace, that you may faithfully live together in this life and in the age to come have life everlasting.